Reading is a wonderful human activity. In studies, we read to gain knowledge. In daily life, we read to relax and entertain ourselves. As designers, we also need to read the physical environment, the nature, and the city. We use Google Earth to have the first grip on a place. For instance, from the Google map of Amsterdam, we can see where is the old city center and how it is formed in rings. By reading this map, we not only know the specific locations of a building, a park, highways, or canals, but also how these elements together composed Amsterdam as it is. Similarly to the Google map, but in-person direct experience, when we take a flight, we can read the city from a bird's eye view so as to understand the city on a large scale. For example, this picture was taken during the taking off right after a heavy snowstorm in Detroit. We can clearly see the neighborhoods that are emptying out. This shows a well-known phenomenon that, due to the decline of the industry, enormous plots are abandoned. We can also see how the holes spread over the city in relation with the infrastructures and the build-up areas. Scaled down, when we are in a car driving on the ring roads or highways, going through the city, seeing different neighborhoods, we can get an impression on how these neighborhoods are separated and at the same time connected by infrastructures. Or, when we are walking in the city, having immediate experiences with the buildings, pavement, trees, and people, we can also understand what kind of physical environment facilitates certain types of behaviors and what kind of behaviors activate physical spaces. On all scales, on the one hand, we have the real world, and on the other hand, we have the abstract domain in human mind. In between, we need tools and methods to convey relevant information. What is actually happening in the black box? What are the thinking processes in relation to urban design? In this lecture, we are going to explain the successive phases, which can be seen as a kind of step-by-step explanation of what is happening in the urban design thinking process. They are description, interpretation, reduction, and abstraction. Of course, these steps are neither rigid nor linear. Experienced designers might skip certain steps or reverse the sequence. The design ideas are generated during these steps. However, as a beginner, I highly recommend you to train yourself according to these steps. In the descriptive phase, first of all, you can try to use text, the most familiar tool to express oneself and describe a space. For instance, this is a piece of text written by a student from TU Delft, describing a place in his dream. The street was colorful and full of life. It had a lot of green, plants, and trees, aware of my senses, breath. From this text, we could see that he already set up his focus and interest in the built environment. Then, you can try to use descriptive drawings to illustrate the spaces and what we want to tell. For instance, this is a series of perspective drawings showing the sequential spaces and atmosphere in a neighborhood in Paris. Descriptive drawings can also be tracing maps. For instance, this is a series of maps indicating the building blocks' growth over time in the city of Leiden. Tracing maps are factual drawings describing the situation in the real world. For instance, these series of maps are used quite often in practice. They reveal the current situation of land use, building age, traffic condition, etc. The written text, perspective drawings, tracing maps are the professional or architectural means to describe the physical environment. The descriptive phase is a link between the actual world and our mind. The interpretation is a selective and experimental phase. By taking elements apart and manipulating them, you will be able to build up your own understanding of spaces. This is a map of Rome in 1748 made by Nolli. It shows public spaces and building mass. The public space networks not only include outside urban places, like squares and streets, but also the interior public spaces where the public has access to. For example, the churches and some public buildings. This is an analysis of Rotterdam by Professor Pollenbaum. He took the city apart into three layers: the infrastructures, the street networks, and the underlying landscape. He concluded as a red map how these subsystems work together and structure Rotterdam. Sometimes, you can also use comics to show your narrative. Reduction drawing is a particular depth morphological school approach. The intention is to further reduce information, leave out the irrelevant elements, extract the essential aspect from urban areas depending on the theme, in order to reveal a certain logic and structure through the drawing process. It is a process as well as a well-presented product. The work of Reinhersen was fundamental in developing the Delft method, the reduction. The example used here is a part of analysis of Delft town center. The reduction drawing clearly shows the formal structure of the city that is much harder to read in the left aerial photograph. The previous Rotterdam analysis is an example of combination of layer approach and reduction drawings. Based on the evidence and through personal interpretation of the spaces in the previous phases, in this phase, so-called abstraction, you need to make a huge jump in your minds towards a more abstract form or form system. Here are some examples from the students' work in the Urbanism Master Program at TU Delft. Students are asked to make a city portrait based on their analysis of the city. They use models made from random materials, such as some leaves of the street, cracked plates, or spaghetti, or anything that can deliver a strong image and explain a concept. Again, the description, interpretation, reduction, and abstraction are not rigid step-by-step linear processes. You can start to train yourself following these steps, and once you are experienced with it, you or your brain will automatically combine and integrate them. Most importantly, while you are doing all this, the design ideas are generated in real time. Enjoy!